Hi there, everyone. My name is Gabe, and I'm here at Royal Botanical Gardens, located in Burlington, Ontario. RBG is Canada's largest botanical garden, and it's also home to over 50 species at risk, including 4 species of turtles. This is a Midland Painted Turtle, and you may have seen turtles like my buddy Salvador here, sunning themselves on the logs in Cootes Paradise Marsh, and they depend almost entirely on wetland habitat to survive. It's really where they're happiest and healthiest. You can tell it's a Midland Painted Turtle because of a few things. The number one thing to look for is the yellow markings on the side of his head. Oh, sorry, buddy. And the yellow, sometimes orange markings on its head and neck. And then also the scutes. You see the edge of its scutes here, yellow, dark orange, and red markings on the sides of its shell. Turtles like Salvador here can live 30 to 40 years in the wild, and that's pretty standard for a lot of different turtle species, including the ones that you find at the pet store. So it is mid-spring now here at the marsh, and you will start to see these guys emerge from what's called brumation. That's like hibernation that takes place at the bottom of the marsh. And you'll especially start seeing females. They are out looking for nesting sites. So they're going to leave the marsh, start digging in sandy soil, sandy rocky soil, and lay their eggs. And once those eggs hatch, those hatchlings are probably gonna make their way back to many of the similar wetlands that their parents came from. And that's because wetlands are the perfect place for these species. They are filled with all of the shelter that turtles need, all of the places to sun, but also all of the food sources. So algae, invertebrates, even fish are what these guys love, and the marsh is the perfect habitat for them. Cootes Paradise Nature Sanctuary is home to hundreds of species, not just the Midland Painted Turtle, and it's part of what makes Royal Botanical Gardens a biodiversity hotspot. RBG is committed to making sure that these species are protected. Unfortunately, there are threats to the well-being of this species. One of those threats is road mortality. Females right now are leaving the marsh to find a good spot to dig their nest and lay their eggs. Sometimes that path out of the marsh takes them across a road, and so there is the risk that they could get hit by a car. Another threat to these turtles is nest predation. So once the eggs have been buried in the nest, there really isn't anything protecting them from scavengers and predators like raccoons, foxes, and skunks who come along and dig up the eggs and eat them before they have a chance to hatch. The good news, there are things you can do to help. First thing, if you see a turtle crossing the road, if it's safe to do so for yourself, you can help them cross to the other side in the direction that they were going. The second thing is you can consider supporting wildlife corridor initiatives. Now, these are essentially projects to make it really hard for turtles to cross in the most dangerous sections, and in some cases, to actually give them tunnels or passages to cross roads safely without being exposed to road danger. The third thing you can consider doing is look up an app called iNaturalist and use it to report your sightings of this species at risk. iNaturalist makes it really easy to spot and to identify a turtle and to report that you've seen it. And it's also a really helpful tool for helping you identify species that you're not familiar with. You can also help native species of turtles by not feeding wild animals in nature sanctuaries. So, if you think about some of the animals that you might see on your next hike, chipmunks, raccoons, maybe skunks, those are species that don't need our help to find the food that they need. So, when we subsidize them by giving them additional food, their population is going to increase, and as their population increases, so does the pressure on the species that they feed off of, like the eggs of the Midland Painted Turtle. Thanks for joining me today, folks. I hope you learned something about the Midland Painted Turtle and what Royal Botanical Gardens is doing to protect biodiversity. So if you see a turtle on its way across the road next time, if it's safe to do so, give it a hand. If you're doing something neat to protect biodiversity near you, leave us a comment below. We'd love to hear from you. And check out our YouTube channel for more videos like this about biodiversity and the animals that live near us. Take care, guys. Until next time.